After Matt and Mark graduated from college, I felt that I needed to do something. I felt that God was calling me to do something, and I wasn't quite sure what. And when Bob Prescott came into our Sunday school class and showed a video from the Love Ladies Center, I was like, that's it. You know, that's exactly where I can serve. And so I started going out there one night a week and picking a topic and building scripture around it. The Love Ladies Center houses close to 400 women and children. It's in the old East End Hospital off of 59 over by the airport. And the majority of these women are coming in out of prison. They have been in prison due to their, you know, drug habits. Many are there due to domestic abuse. They're now seeing a larger number come in due to the economy and homelessness. There are women there who are college educated that get caught up in drugs, meth, embezzlement. I would say the majority are there due to whatever they had to do to get their drugs, their cocaine, their meth, whatever they had to do to get them there, whether it was prostitution or theft. A lot just start out with normal backgrounds, and one turn takes them down a road of no return, so to speak. At first, they probably treat you with not skepticism, but they're just not sure who you are. And so I tell them what my story was, how I didn't come to the Lord till age 34, so my past doesn't even come close to an nth of what these women have gone through. But I think opening up yourself to a little bit of vulnerability as to who you are allows the conversation to flow back and forth. What we're really excited about is a new opportunity that's come up for the Love Ladies, and it is a thrift store. It will be located in the old Circuit City building on Crestwood Boulevard. And this will just be an incredible opportunity for these women to provide some income, not only for themselves, but for the Love Ladies Center. So as you look around the city, you're gonna see these pink Love Ladies Center collection boxes. So that's certainly one way that anybody can donate any of their items. Another way, to give you an example, is the Church of Brook Hills had a clothing drive. The Love Ladies Center literally brought an 18-wheeler out to their property. And on a Saturday, they had a clothing drive that brought in over 7,000 pounds of clothing. One of the other ways, or many ways, of volunteering is they need teachers, they need mentors, they need tutors for the children. Not just for the children, but you have some women that only have a third grade reading level. So if you have a heart to sit down with some women during the daytime and tutor them, that's an incredible opportunity. The building needs maintenance and paint and construction projects. So if we've got anybody out there that would love to work on that, there's a Friday night game night where, you know, perhaps some college kids can go out there and have a Friday night game night. You know, with that many women, with that many hospital rooms that have actually been turned into mini apartments, you have a lot of rooms that would need a little bit of TLC. So they call them Sunday school makeover rooms, and it's where a Sunday school class goes out and gets the matching bedspreads and the draperies and maybe the cute little carpet and maybe a lamp, just something to make that room feel a little bit more like home. Any gift that anybody has, I can assure you that the Love Ladies Center would find a place to use your talents, to use your skills to further the kingdom of God and to help these women re-enter the workforce and create a positive home environment for their children that perhaps these children have never had before. So to have a godly man or woman or a husband and wife team to come in and teach them the proper way of how you manage a home, how you just manage the day from getting your children up, getting them to school, you going to work, planning a meal, these women have no clue how to do that. So to have someone come out and do a class on that would just be an incredible, incredible opportunity for these women. Set them on the right track, showing how God wants their lives to be centered around Him from the moment they wake up to putting their children to bed at night. Last year in 2009, the Love Ladies Center was able, through the help with DHR, they were able to get 126 children out of foster care and back reunited with their moms. Last year, they had over 240 baptisms of women and children there at the Love Ladies Center. And I realized that when I walked out at night and got back into my car, I would just sit there and just say, I was humbled by being in their presence and just saying, thank you, Lord, for allowing me to meet these women and to be here. I'm Sandy Mogul, and I'm touching my world locally.